Okay, this is in response to a question that's been going around for going on a week now on Facebook vintage groups. The original poster was saying that she's having problems, that her feed dogs on her 66 aren't coming up enough through the needle plate to move the fabric. Well, we're going to take a close, in-depth look at how the feed dog mechanism works for how the feed dogs actually get lifted up and down, because I'm seeing a lot of stuff that's, well, frankly, making me crazy. A lot of incorrect information. So let's just look at the mechanism and set the record straight. Okay, now, this is an as-found 66 red eye. This one I think is from like 1915 or 1916, something like that. So this is pretty old. It's pretty funky. That's okay. We'll deal with the filth. Okay. Shaft across the top is your feed dog rock shaft. What that's doing is it's making the feed dogs go fore and aft inside the needle plate. It's got zero to do with the up and down motion. What has to do with the up and down motion is this shaft here. This is the lifter shaft. Now this, we're gonna take this apart so you can see how this works. Let me get a big old screwdriver here. We're gonna take the lifter shaft off if I can get the screw loose. Okay, one screw. Of course, I picked the longest screwdriver I had available in that size. Let me find my ratchet here. Get in here with something a little bit smaller. Like I said, this machine's kind of funky. Okay. And I'll turn the hand wheel a little bit. Get that out of there. There we go. It finally broke free. Like I said, this machine is disgusting. You see this bearing on the end of the feed dog arm itself. The feed dog is on the other side of that screw. As the machine is turning, the rock shaft is moving back and forth. That is moving the rock shaft. That is moving the feed dogs. Here on the bell crank, you will see a cam that is cut into it. The cam goes at a bit, it slopes. This little bearing rides in that cam and gives the up and down motion. This little bearing on the feed dog arm gets hooked into this portion of this shaft so that as the feed dogs are, as the bell crank is oscillating back and forth, that is making the feed dogs go up and down. And this bearing here is just guiding the feed dogs at whatever height this sets it at. So, for example, I'm going to put this back in here real quick. Oh, that is so filthy. Of course, I should have taken a clean machine. That would have made things a lot easier for myself. Okay, that's back in. So let me put the screw back on. Now, this screw is the pivot point for the feed dog lifting arm. Now note, I'm going to turn the hand wheel. This does not move much. This bearing is following the cut in the bell crank. The cut in the bell crank is actually the cam. These bearings act as cam followers. And you can see the up and down motion. It's not much. So, I don't care how much crud you build up in here, it's not going to prevent it from going up and down. The up and down is determined by the cam on the bell crank, not in the fork that's grasping the bearing on coming off of the feed arm. If you have so much crud inside your bell crank, your machine's not going to move because the bearing has no place to go. Here, let me take this linkage off here real quick, and I'll show you what I mean. by having no place to go. Take the hook linkage off real quick. That out of the way. Now, make sure there's no needle on this. There is. Okay. Pull this needle off. Okay. Now, as I'm turning this, let me put the camera into a better position so you can see. Watch the action of that bearing inside that cam. There's not much motion there. So, it remains. If your feed dogs are not coming up enough to engage the fabric through the needle plate, your feed dogs are adjusted wrong. There's nothing you can do inside this cam, with one exception. If you have this style of bell crank where you have the outside nut, if the nut is loose and the bell crank is wobbling up and down, yeah, that might do it. But other than that, well, or if you have the other style where it's a bolt going through and it's loose, and if the bell crank is wobbling up and down in relation to the bed of the machine, that's the only way you can prevent them from coming up. Other than that, it's your feed dog adjustment. My apologies if this gets a little bouncy. I've got a lot of magnification going on here. This screw here, the feed dog screw, loosen that screw, push on the bottom end of the feed dog, so it'll be down in here. You can push on that once that screw is loosened. Quick demo. Here I've got the screw, and I'm going to, from the top, I'm pushing the feed dogs back through the plate. Right, you can see the bottom of the feed dogs right here, right now. Okay? I'm going to push those back down. So what you want to do is you want to have the feed dogs so that they're in the upper portion of the travel and in the middle of the travel, and then adjust it, adjust the loosen with this screw loose, get the feed dogs coming through slightly, just lightly tighten it. Don't tighten, just snug it. Make sure you adjust so 80% of the height of the teeth are coming through the needle plate. Once you have it in that position, tighten that screw on the bottom. So there you have it. The only things it can be is a loose fastener holding the bell crank or the feed dog screw in the wrong position. Hope that helps.